Jack had made it himself, and was very proud of it. There was a door and several windows, and through the top was stuck a stovepipe that led from a small stove inside. The door was reached by a flight of three steps, and there was a good floor on which was arranged some furniture that was quite comfortable. It is certain that Jack Pumpkinhead might have had a much finer house to live in had he wanted it, for Ozma loved the stupid fellow who had been her earliest companion, but Jack preferred his pumpkin house as it matched himself very well, and in this he was not stupid after all. The body of this remarkable person was made of wood, branches of trees of various sizes having been used for the purpose. This wooden framework was covered by a red shirt with white spots on it, blue trousers, a yellow vest, a jacket of green and gold, and stout leather shoes. The neck was a sharpened stick on which the pumpkin head was set, and the eyes, ears, nose, and mouth were carved on the skin of the pumpkin, very like a child's jack-o'-lantern. The house of this interesting creation stood in the center of a vast pumpkin field, where the vines grew in profusion and bore pumpkins of extraordinary size, as well as those which were smaller. Some of the pumpkins now ripening on the vines were almost as large as Jack's house, and he told Dorothy he intended to add another pumpkin to his mansion. The travelers were cordially welcomed to this quaint domicile and invited to pass the night there, which they had planned to do. The patchwork girl was greatly interested in Jack and examined him admiringly. "You are quite handsome," she said, "but not as really beautiful as the Scarecrow.